The outcome of an entity relationship diagram will have data models, right? So it'll have database one, it'll have database two, it'll have database three. You'll say how these three databases are connected, and it can actually represent the flow of information or relationship through primary, secondary, and tertiary key. That is known as a data model. And the way we do it is in two parts. First of all, before you implement it using any database technology or techniques or methods, you should be able to logically group them or logically assign them or logically relate them. Only then can you take it and put it in a physical form. It's not very easy to put an entity relationship diagram or a data model directly into a database, because you'll then have, if you miss out one connection, the whole thing goes for a toss. It becomes like noodles. So first step is to determine the logical description or relationship between these entities through what is known as entity relationship diagram. So you'll take a piece of paper, you'll draw all the data entities, how they are stored, where they are stored, and how do they look, connect them up. Then you use a tool. The tool could be a database management system like Oracle or MS SQL Server, or it could be DB2 or MS Access, or even Excel sheets. Once you've designed the relationship diagram logically, which is not in a physical form, but you've drawn it somewhere, and you take that in and put it into a tool, you get into a physical model. When you put it in a physical model is when you actually make that ability for data to be accessed. You can't access the data when you put it on paper.
Absolutely.
Right? But you have to put it somewhere. But on the paper, you say this data is going to be related to this via this key, and then therefore it will look like that. If you take that and implement it in a database tool, it becomes physically available to you. That's the difference between a logical model and a physical model.